Wildlife officials feel they have to forge a partnership.
To keep both people and bears as safe as possible, they are holding bear meetings in neighborhoods where bears frequently roam.
WESH News' Dave McDaniel joining us live in an area where nuisance bear complaints have been skyrocketing, with the effort starting tonight. Dave.
Well, Martha, that's exactly the case. All up and down Markham's Road in Seminole County, we have seen an increase in the number of nuisance bear complaints. And of course, it wasn't all that long ago in early December when a woman along this area was injured badly by a bear. That's exactly why wildlife officials are holding a series of meetings, and the first of those is this evening, working with neighbors and neighborhoods to see how they can more safely live around bears. The December mauling was the worst incident in state history between a bear and a person. Two bears were trapped and killed before the bear linked to the injuries through DNA was caught, and the decision was made not to put that bear and her two cubs down.
Seems like every year the human bear conflicts keep going up and up.
These neighborhood meetings were in the planning stages well before December. FWC feels more people need to know about how to act around bears and how not to act. No pet food or bird seed outside and keeping garbage out of reach. Photos taken with bears into garbage may be cute, but that's the exact behavior which needs to be discouraged.
It really does the same thing. It keeps them close to your residence, and then at some point in time, they just want to become friends. And we don't want people and bears to be friends. We want the bears to be in the woods. If the bear is getting a little too close, or and you're inviting him in to get pictures and that sort of thing, that ends badly for the bear in the end.
The meetings will do more than spread the message that you need to keep bears moving by making them uncomfortable. No food and maybe some noise which keeps them moving. They'll recruit people at these meetings to spread the word to people who cannot attend.
If we could get people to make bears uncomfortable, not have any reason to be in your yard in the form of some food that they're getting, we don't have to respond because there are no bear issues.
Now, tonight's meeting at the Markham Woods Church starts around 6:30. It's expected to last until 8 o'clock this evening. Six more meetings are scheduled before the end of the month. All that list of meetings, that entire list, can be found on WESH.com. Reporting live in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.